Remington, I stole from you. I stole from you myself. What's up, guys? Welcome to the video. Fardien here from wolfofsiek.com. And today, we're going to talk about a little bit of drama in the fitness industry regarding the Anabar. And honestly, my thoughts about it, about the whole Remington James stealing stuff from others with recipes, etc., 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 it's not good. He's quite, like, busted. If you know what I mean. I mean, like, the evidence is clear. Although, I do not think it's that bad of a problem because he shared all recipes for free anyway on his YouTube channel. So, I don't really get what the problem is. But, Remington, I stole from you. I stole from you myself. I just want to mention it. You're only gonna see me where I'm paid to be. I'm only watching TV. It's my intro. It's your music. I use your music for my intro. And I like it. But I did DM you, alright? I just wanted to talk about protein bars. What makes a good protein bar? I'm just gonna give you my opinion. I tasted the Anabar myself and I liked it. It was delicious. And to be honest, the calories are higher compared to other protein bars. But what most people do not realize is that it's 65 grams. Most protein bars are 50 grams. And then the calories are around 200 to 220. Greg Doucette says that it's a high calorie bar. It's good for bulking. But is that really the case? I mean, like, the protein bar is 65 grams and has like 270 calories, I believe. 70 calories extra compared to other bars, or 50 calories. I mean, like, it's not that bad. And you know what's ironic? Greg Doucette is coming out with his own protein bar. I haven't tasted that one, but it should be lower calorie, right? But I gotta be honest with you, if it's lower calorie, I guess it's around 50 grams. And I know for a fact that I'm right, all right? So 50 grams, most often, just look at the label, it's lower calorie. Of course, because it's less in weight, right? So yeah, the whole situation about the Anabars, I think it's kind of sad, you know? It's sad because Remington, he looked up to Greg Doucette, and I like Remington, you know? He's like, I don't know, man. I like the dude, and he was always very honest, but badly enough, he stole some recipes. Maybe he didn't see it that way. He apologized. I don't get what the problem is. But yeah, people click on videos for drama, right? And this is drama. Drama, drama. I guess this gets more clicks because it's drama. Why do all you guys like drama? I don't understand. But no problem. If you're here and you're new, subscribe to the channel because I like science and I like talking about stuff and giving information. All right, but let's watch the video, all right? Because Remington James made a response about the Anabars. It's his own bar. I would do the same.
You know that expression that when it rains, it pours? Well, right now it's pouring. Now understand all these videos that come out, the drama stuff, it's fun to watch, it's good entertainment, but let me tell you, when the spotlight's on you and you're in the hot seat, it loses all its luster.
Most people, when they like, when they look at the drama and you're a creator yourself, it looks fun, but it's not when it's like about you, you know, and you have like bad publicity.
Hashtag not fun. My dog got fixed today, and I swear he's having more fun than I am. So let's go ahead and get right into this video, man. You already know why you're here. Greg just dropped a video basically trashing the Anna bar, saying my apology was BS, saying he lost all respect for me. There's probably some more stuff in there. I literally just watched it, but only watched it once. If I missed anything, y'all let me know. So the first thing I want to cover is the Anna bar. So Greg said that our calories are too high. It's a junk bar. You know, he imagines it tastes good, but everything else about it is pretty bad. He would never, ever recommend it. And he was also sure...
How ironic, right? Greg says dropping his own protein bar as well. Well, to be honest, yeah, it's like, it's higher calorie, but it's 65 grams, like I said before. And I have never seen a bar of 65 grams that is lower calorie than, that's around 200 to 220 calories, because that would be amazing. It doesn't exist. If I'm wrong,
to let you know that he's got a bar dropping in 6 months that is going to be all of the things that the Anna bar isn't. And before I get any further into this video, I want you guys to know that even though Greg appears to hate my guts and he wants to take away everything that I've built, I still have mad respect for the man. I owe him a lot. I really do. And regardless of what happens, he pulls up tomorrow and lights my house on.
Oh man, that's a hard pill to swallow. Oh my God. I would be mad, to be honest, because I would be mad. It's just me.
Fire. Even though then I'd probably be pretty mad, I still can't ever take back what he's done for me. So, Greg, if you are watching this, I'm sorry for disappointing you. I really am. But when we decided to go to work on a bar, we wanted to have a bar that was absolutely incredible. A bar that tasted amazing. That was our number one goal. If we had three goals for a bar, the first goal was that it was incredible. Second goal was that it had at least 20 grams of protein. And the third goal, we weren't going to do weird fibers. We weren't going to do sugar alcohol.
Okay, so the main problem with sugar alcohols is like some people, like a lot of people, they get like digestive problems for because of the sugar alcohols. Sugar alcohols are, for example, erythritol, xylitol, you know, shit that is in like chewing gum and shit. But I mean, like I have a friend, every time we get a bar, it's like he's always like farting. He's farting and he has digestive issues. I do not have the same thing. I consume a lot of erythritol, don't get me wrong. But it's like, I get why it's not in the bar, all right? And if the goal is to make it taste good, I understand that you are putting things like peanuts and real sugar, honey, because shit tastes amazing. And if it's higher calorie that way, and it tastes amazing, and it got protein, why the hell not, right? But sugar alcohols can also have a good effect, you know? It's not all that bad. It can feed your gut bacteria, which can, yeah. Which is a good thing, right? Because these days, we do all things that affect our gut bacteria in a bad way. So it's more like, what kind of person are you? Are you really sensitive? People with irritable bowel syndrome or digestive issues, I would not recommend. I would just completely cut out the sugar alcohols, all right? Because that shit is not, at that moment of time, that's not good if you have those symptoms. And what I also noticed, people who really feel good on a carnivore diet most often think that they are like, that meat is the cure. All right, I believe in meat. I believe meat is good for you. It has a lot of nutrients in it if you eat nose to tail. But most often it's just because of they are removing the FODMAPs. We all have FODMAPs that we are not really digesting well. Like think of gluten and sugar alcohols. It's also a FODMAP. And when you eliminate all FODMAPs from your diet, most often you feel really better and good. And also with autoimmune diseases, it all starts within the gut. So if your gut is healthy, it's only better for you, right? If you want me to go deeper into sugar alcohols, etc., any sweeteners, I don't know, put it in the comments and I'll make a video about it, you know, because I do whatever the fuck you want me to do.
Is that if we're going off of like the macros of like a Quest bar, I know there's a couple bars that are like a little lower in calories, but if I pull up a Quest bar right here, which one is this? We're looking at that one, chocolate peanut butter right there. This bar has 10 fat, 22 carbs, 20 grams of protein, but only 210 calories. Now, if you know how to do math, you understand that something's wrong here. How can our bars only have like one more gram of fat and a couple more grams of carbs, but be that many calories more? Well, the whole thing here that I've been trying to explain to people, I've been trying to do more research on this, so just, I'm gonna let you know where my head's at with it, right? A lot of these other bars have all this fiber in them. You can do this sneaky stuff with a label where you're like subtracting fiber off and you're taking calories away. You don't have to report them on your label. Like, our label does none of that. If I literally...
That's true. I mean, like, people always think like the net carbs thing, you know, that if you have fiber and carbs, you can subtract the fiber content from the carbohydrate content, which will make it lower calorie. But even the guy who came up with that idea really regrets this, that he came up with this, because it's not true. All right. You can't, fiber also has calories. It has less calories, but it also has calories. And I don't want to get too deep into this, but what makes a good bar for me is that when it tastes good, it's crunchy, and it's got some chocolate, you know, white chocolate, maybe some nuts, these nuts. That would be amazing. That's an amazing bar. What I do not like, sorry Quest bar, but a bar that's like, that tastes like chewing gum, you know, like cardboard. That's shit that you... I don't like it. It's not even worth the calories, all right? I'd rather have more calories then with the bar that tastes good than lower calories with the cardboard bar, you know? That's just my opinion, and I don't want to get too deep into this stuff, but that's what I think what makes a good bar. And yeah, sugar, alcohols, yeah, etc. I hope it was kind of informative and not too dramatic. But if you liked the video, like it, subscribe, and see you next time. Much love.